happy anniversary.
They are so beautiful. Huh, Arnold?
Mm-hmm. So what did you guys get each other?
Yeah, 31. What gift is that? Silver, ivory?
Oh, we got each other the new cable subscription.
Oh, great.
It's a lot of channels.
Hello, welcome to What the Flick. I am Christy, this is Alonzo. We're gonna talk about Meryl Streep and Tommy Lee Jones doing it. Because you wanted to see that this summer. That is the definition of a summer blockbuster.
It's not in 3D, sadly.
Oh, I wish it had been. How fun. Tommy Lee Jones' scowl in 3D just pops off the screen. We're talking about Hope Springs, which I think we were both rather surprised by.
Yeah, not a movie I was expecting in a lot of ways. It was very much a pleasant summer surprise. So yeah, Meryl Streep and Tommy Lee Jones have been married for 31 years. They live in Omaha. He's a tax prep guy. And they basically are roommates at this point. He sleeps in another room and they don't touch and they barely talk, and she is finally fed up with it. So she takes her own money out and buys them a week in Maine to do intensive couples therapy with therapist Steve Carell, and they're off to the races.
Kay and Arnold, I'm so glad you're here.
Well, that makes one of us.
You two have come here to try to restore intimacy to your marriage.
This is insane. We're not 22 years old anymore.
I would like to assign you your first exercise. Tonight, I would like you to spend a period of time with your arms around one another.
I think we better stop.
So the ads for this film do it a huge disservice.
It makes it look like it's going to be a big Viagra joke or something.
It looks really hacky, and like there are only a couple of jokes really in the whole movie. It's really more of a serious movie than you're gonna expect. And I was kind of dreading it going into it. Because either the ads look hacky or really mawkish.
Totally, yeah. It looked very sort of, not even Lifetime, like Oxygen.
Yeah, and it's none of that. And it's what I love about it is actually what is not funny about it, which is it comes from this very quiet, honest place. And I don't think you need to have been married for 31 years
to recognize.
Relate,
yeah,
right?
No,
you don't have to even be married. I mean, relationships, people get in ruts and you don't have sex for a while and you just fall into a routine you don't like. It happens to everybody.
Sure.
And they convey this so beautifully and in such lovely and relatable ways. And a lot of it has to do with the performances.
Absolutely. It's a really smart movie. The screenplay is terrific. It's mm-hmm. first-time writer.
Vanessa Taylor.
Vanessa Taylor. She writes for, I think, like Game of Thrones.
And Alias.
And, yeah, several shows that you wouldn't necessarily expect this would be in her wheelhouse. Mm-hmm. And what's great about this movie is that it's about a couple going to therapy, and it's about a couple going to therapy.
Yes.
Like, there are long sequences where they are in Steve Carell's office talking to each other, and that's the whole scene, and it's riveting.
Right.
You're thinking, wow, they're really just letting this play out, and not in a way that a lot of American movies would. And Steve Carell is not ever going for the joke. He does nothing in this movie but very quietly ask questions, he gives them assignments, but he really recedes back and lets them do all the heavy lifting.
Right, he's like the solid straight man there. He finds the exact right tone. But I love how subtle Meryl Streep is in this. And that's not shocking, she can do everything, of course.
Sure.
Interesting to see her with this director, David Frankel, who also did Devil Wears Prada,
right,
which is one of her showiest, meatiest, bitchiest roles ever, and she's totally great in it. This is a place where she's great in a really believably lovely, kind of goofy, kind of vulnerable way. And when they're sitting there on opposite sides of the couch and there's just this silence that just weighs everything down in between them, you just feel for her, like she wants to be loved and she's putting herself out there, and yet she may also be partly to blame for the situation that they're in. There's no judgment of anybody here.
Yeah, and well, you know, the movie is not the wacky comedy the ads promise. It's also not a bummer. I mean, it's fun to watch, and there are moments of laughter, but there are also just moments of genuine sort of human empathy with these people. And Tommy Lee Jones
is really good. He
blew me away. Mm-hmm. And long story there. But anyway, this is one of those movies where he comes out. The Tommy Lee Jones we know, he's grumpy and he's got the walls up and he's he's funny doing that.
Yeah.
But then as the movie proceeds, those walls have to come down, and that's what happens to him in therapy. And it's probably one of the more vulnerable performances we've ever seen him do.
Yeah, it's a bit of a mystery, this film, and you don't expect that going into it, but you wonder from the very start what happened to these people, what happened to this man, because she seems so lovely and she's reaching out, and how did he get so cold and so walled off? And so there is a bit of a mystery of, you know, waiting to find out, ooh, what happened with these people? And there are no easy answers.
And also there's no subplots in this movie. It's about them, right, and about their marriage, and are they going to be able to work it out? And that's frankly enough to carry this film.
Right. I mean, like, Elizabeth Shue is in it for like one scene. She's a bartender in one scene.
Yeah, Becky Ann Baker and Mimi Rogers, there's all these really recognizable actors who have one scene and then you never see them again. It's about the two of them. Gene Smart is in it.
In like one scene, two
scenes. There are a couple of on-the-nose song choices I could have lived without.
I was going to say that exact same thing. There's some very literal, painfully literal musical choices. A couple of kind of hokey comic situations, but for the most part, this is really surprisingly good and surprisingly moving.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's a couple scenes that kind of got to me.
I mean, like, if you're in a relationship, if you see this with your significant other, you will be ready for conversations afterwards. But whoever you see it with, you really should see it. It's a dynamite movie.
Yeah, you don't have to be 61 years old or whatever they are to appreciate it.
This is the rare American movie that takes the orgasms of a woman over 50 seriously, which is a very rare thing.
And there's your blurb for the ads. Okay, what's your number, my friend?
I say 8.8.
I say 8. That gives us an 8.4 average. It is doing very, very well in Tomato Land. It has a 77%. It opened just this past Wednesday, so it's been out for a few days, and I think it's wide, right?
I believe so, yeah.
So, I mean, you'd be surprised, but go find it. Thanks, bye.